Welcome to Exoplanet Radio. I'm Tony Darnell. One of the big questions we are trying to answer in exoplanet astronomy is, just how common are habitable planets? We already know that exoplanets themselves are extremely common. Astronomers tell us there are on average 1.6 planets for every star in our galaxy. So, there are more planets than stars out there. And that by itself is pretty amazing. But what we really want to know is, where's the life? How common are planets that could potentially support life? The answer so far has eluded us, and the news reports and studies coming out are a bit contradictory. For example, as this recording is made, in July of 2023, over the course of just 3 days, two studies were announced. One is titled, Potentially Habitable Worlds Are 100 Times More Common Than We Thought. And a few days later, latest James Webb Space Telescope images hint that habitable worlds are not common. Now, from these headlines, it's pretty clear that we are still sorting out how common habitability is, which is understandable because we've only just started studying exoplanets. Astronomers are using every tool at their disposal to understand the habitability question of exoplanets. Space telescopes like Webb, Spitzer, Hubble, Kepler, TESS, and others are setting their sights on finding and confirming exoplanets, arranging them by size, and whether they exist in the habitable zone of their star. Ground-based telescopes are measuring the wobble in the spectra of stars to determine planet masses and orbital periods. But the real breakthrough will be measuring exoplanets directly and observing their disks when possible. Right now, only the James Webb Space Telescope stands equipped to make those measurements. The main things JWST can show us with respect to the habitability of a given exoplanet are whether it has an atmosphere, and if it has one, what are some of the major chemical components of that atmosphere, including water, and crucially, are there any biosignatures in the atmosphere? Biosignatures are those elements that are produced by life and accumulate in an atmosphere to detectable levels. And what are they? Astronomers are taking the approach that since we know what compounds life on Earth produces, let's look for those first. What might the spectrum of Earth look like if it was transplanted to another, slightly different, Earth-like planet? Things like an oxygen-rich atmosphere, certain methane compounds, ammonia, and carbon monoxide are good things to see for a start. The trick for JWST will be getting enough orbits to make good measurements. And a primary candidate is the fascinating system of TRAPPIST-1, home to several worlds that can harbor life, are close to their star, and orbit quickly. So let's not be too hard on astronomers this early in the search. Right now, our observations are preliminary and rough. As they improve, our understanding of whether habitable planets are common or not will only get better. Exoplanet Radio is produced by Deep Astronomy. Music is by Geodesium and available at LochNessProductions.com. Get all episodes at ExoplanetRadio.com or anywhere you get podcasts.